What is going on, Guardians? Briar Rabbit here. Welcome to Sharded or Keep It, the series where I make an argument both for and against dismantling an item, and you make the decision. This week, we'll be making the big decision for the ultra-rare legendary scout rifle, Treads Upon Stars. But first, let's take a look at the results from last week's weapon, Kolovance's Duty. Kolovance's Duty is a legendary scout rifle earned by competing in the Iron Banner. The weapon is most notable for its extremes, having the lowest rate of fire and highest impact in its class. Great range, poor base stability, and an abysmal aim assist value round out this gun's base stats. So why would we dismantle this weapon of the Iron Wolves? In PvP, it has huge potential, but it's very hard to use. It can kill in 3 headshots, but in practice, due to its low aim assist and slow rate of fire, this can be difficult to achieve. If you do start missing headshots, that slow rate of fire really hurts, and the gun goes from having one of the fastest time to kills to one of the slowest. That slow fire rate also makes anti-sniping difficult. Firing every 0.4 seconds, it gives an enemy sniper a lot of time to recover from flinch, aim, and fire. Faster firing scouts are better at harassing snipers, in my opinion. And it's very difficult to use at close range. If you are out of secondary ammo or just don't have time to switch weapons, expect to lose the gunfight. In PvE, with the perks I have, it's unexceptional. With a better role, it could become viable, but frankly, there's some really strong competition out there for outstanding PvE scout rifles. More on that later in the video. Arguments for keeping this weapon? A 3 headshot crit kill in PvP equals a 0.8 second time to kill. That's fast. That's real fast. If you have the skill to pull this off consistently, it is one of the best weapons in the game, but be careful. Body shots take 5 shots to get a kill, and that moves the time to kill up to 1.6 seconds. Also, if yours happen to roll with crowd control, it's capable of a 2-shot kill. Mine didn't, but I wish it did. So those were my arguments, and as usual, you guys had a lot to add. Sebastian Bach said, "Shard it, the negatives far outweigh the positives, and unless you have good aim, it's worthless. I have spoken." Angelo Saridan says, "Keep it. Landing those 3 headshots are very easy. Even though there is a Jade Rabbit, it doesn't take your exotic slot." And Dragon's Breath 292 says, "Kolovance's Duty. Call of Duty. Keep it up." In the end, with 211 votes for Keep It and 179 votes for Shard It, Kolovance's Duty keeps its place in the vault. Treads Upon Stars is an ultra-rare legendary scout rifle, which can only be obtained as a random reward. The Shield Brothers, Dust Palace, and Cerberus Vey 3 Strike bosses all have a small chance to drop this weapon, and players will have to farm these strikes to receive it. Once found, players are greeted with a weapon that both feels and looks very familiar. The weapon's base stats are very similar to the Vault of Glass reward weapon, Vision of Confluence. Out of the box, the gun has mid-tier rate of fire and impact, great range, fast reload speed, and poor stability. Nothing extraordinary, so it's the perks that randomly roll on it that will make the difference. And the perks on mine are pretty fucking good. Crowd control grants bonus damage for a short time after a kill. Hand-laid stock massively boosts stability while having almost no noticeable effect on range. And reactive reload grants another damage boost after reloading. 2 separate boosts to damage, plus a perk that boosts its worst stat to very acceptable levels. Yes, please. Deadly perks, rarity, and some nostalgia in one package. Why in the hell would we dismantle it? This one comes down to competition. In PvE play, it's a badass gun, but the scout rifle class right now is chock full of amazing weaponry. The vendor-sold hung jury against mobs of low-tiered enemies is definitely better. Higher stability, faster reloads, and Firefly makes a hard-charging swarm of thralls a non-event. Doom of Kel'Thas with Will of Light and Cocoon is arguably better in the King's Fall raid. Hell, the Mita multi-tool with its bonus to agility or the Jade Rabbit and its seemingly never-exhaustible magazine are both incredible PvE scout rifles. There's a ton of competition here. But Treads Upon Stars has its merit. It's got good aim assist, a good combo of fire rate versus impact, and hand-laid stock making it easier to use. The combo of crowd control and reactive reload means you are constantly getting a damage boost, which is very useful against high-tier enemies, and the range on it is amazing. There are definitely some situations where another scout rifle would be better, but there is no scout, especially legendary, that is better in all situations. This thing is a hard-hitting workhorse, just like its predecessor, Vision of Confluence. But how about PvP? Does this weapon stack up in the Crucible? Again, we have some very stiff competition. The heavy-hitting scouts like Jade Rabbit and Colovance's Duty feature the super fast 0.8 second time to kill if all shots land for crits. The Mita offers unparalleled mobility combined with a fast 0.9 second crit shot time to kill and a blindingly fast equip speed that makes it a favorite for follow-up shots when using a sniper. This gun is a bit slower, with 4 shots to the head killing a guardian in 1 second flat and 5 shots to the body killing in 1.33 seconds. On the surface, unremarkable, but dig a little deeper. Mita needs 6 body shots to get a kill, upping the time to kill to 1.5 seconds. High impact scouts like Colovance's Duty need 5 shots to the body, upping the time to kill to 1.6 seconds. Treads Upon Stars is actually faster with body shots than any of these other guns, making it feel very reliable in PvP. But mine has crowd control. With crowd control active, it can 3-tap the head or 4-shot the body. This isn't something you want to rely on because the effects of crowd control are so brief, but damn, it's a nice bonus. Is it the best scout rifle in the Crucible? No. The benefits of the exotics are really strong here. In the company of other legendaries, it does make a compelling case though. Just like in PvE, it's a solid workhorse. So is that enough to keep this super rare weapon around? Or should it be relegated to the trash heap of destiny, contribute its legendary marks, and be forgotten? That's up to you. In the comments below, cast your vote. Shard it or keep it. And in the next episode, I will act upon your recommendation. Thank you very much for watching. Don't forget to hit that like button if you liked the video. Subscribe if you're new to the channel. And I'll see you guys next time.